Many people are interested in the beautiful objects created by the jeweler Karl Faberge. Geza von Habsburg recently organized a show of his work at the Virginia Museum of Fine Arts. He says people are interested in the work of Faberge because of its link to the last Tsar of Russia. Nicholas II and his family were murdered in 1918 during the Russian Revolution.
One of the major reasons why people bought and buy Fabergé is the connection of Fabergé's art and of Fabergé with the imperial family. He was very close to them, and they commissioned things for their personal use.
Geza von Habsburg gathered more than 500 objects for the exhibit. They included seven of the jeweler's most famous works, the Imperial Easter eggs.
Only 50 were ever created. 40 or 42 are known to exist. Seven are here all at the same time.
Alex NYERGES is director of the Virginia Museum of Fine Arts. The museum has five Imperial Easter eggs.
The eggs are miraculous, marvelous works of detail. They are not just works of art in terms of beauty, but they're mechanically precise.
Each Fabergé egg has movable parts and a surprise inside. The most valuable ones are said to be worth $25 to $30 million. They were made as Easter gifts for the wife of Alexander III. His son, Nicholas II, continued the tradition. The Imperial Easter eggs represent only a part of Karl Faberge's production. During his career, his business produced over 150,000 unique objects. Not all were for the Tsar's family. A crystal egg was made for Emmanuel Nobel, nephew of Alfred Nobel, the man for whom the Nobel Prize is named. Fabergé was also a silversmith and created the Russian crown jewels. But Geza von Habsburg says very little of Fabergé's jewelry and silver work remains.
Of the jewelry, 95% was destroyed by the Bolsheviks. Of the silver, I would say 95% was melted down by the Bolsheviks. They were in dire need of money after the revolution.
What they did not destroy, they sold.
These works started coming out of Russia in the 1920s and in the 1930s, and there was a great, great mania for collecting Fabergé starting in the 1930s in this country. And there were a couple of very key collectors.
Lillian Pratt was one of them. When she died in 1947, she left more than 150 of her Fabergé pieces to the Virginia Museum in Richmond. Today, it has the largest collection of Fabergé outside of Russia. As for Fabergé, he fled Russia during the revolution. He died in Switzerland 2 years later, but his works of art live on. I'm Bob Doty.